It's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll, especially in today's content creation, YouTuber, Instagrammer, influencer world. And building a personal brand, a sustainable personal brand, takes patience, time, and skill. Yeah, but my friends, you've heard it from me first. You actually need some sort of skills. Anyway, in today's video, I'll tell you the four most important skills I believe are vital to actually set yourself apart in this whole big social media world, conglomerate, whatever. Let's roll it. Welcome back, my friends. My name is Dominic. If you're new here, I run a social media marketing agency specifically focused on Instagram. I teach about social media marketing. I teach about personal branding. And a lot of the times people ask me, Dominic, where did you learn all these things that it takes? There's so many things that you have to keep in mind to actually become a social media influencer or a content creator or a YouTuber or just an Instagrammer or whatever, a creative person online. How did you learn these things? The truth is, actually, I learned most of it, pretty much actually everything I do here. My whole career revolves around, you know, me just learning things online. And actually, I'm a really firm believer that you can pretty much learn anything out there online. Well, probably not flying a plane, but you get the idea. You know, all these creative things and stuff like that. Whenever there's a new thing that I kind of want to get into, for example, you know, chalk art, which is, you know, something that I just started to try to get into. Well, you know, it's getting better. I might share the progress on here. Anyway, for example, this and lots of other things, I use a platform called Skillshare. And if you don't know what Skillshare is, we're gonna get into that whole thing in a couple of minutes. So anyway, in this video, I've actually compressed down all these skills that you should need to actually start and setting yourself apart in this big social media world in 4 points, my friends. First of all, basic design and branding principles. And you can say pretty much anything that you want, but knowing the very basics of, you know, why something looks good, design basics and branding basics, you know, they will go a very long way. It can literally make the difference between you being the new guy on the internet who's trying to get his foot in the door, you know, and just trying things out and, you know, just a newbie out there, and between you being this actually cool, emerging, new online personality, online brand, whatever. You know, just by, you know, nailing down some very, very core basic principles of branding and design, and, you know, just knowing why some things might look better than the others will actually go a really long way. And now the thing is, you don't have to dive that deep into that. Just knowing the very, very core basic principles will give you a head start already way. Number two, and, you know, it probably might sound kind of basic, but it's actually true. Basic photography principles. You should actually know how to actually use your camera, but not only how to use the camera, but how to actually take some very, very interesting, you know, pictures, you know. And this is pretty much, especially on Instagram, the most important step on this whole content creation thing, you know, the picture. And if you know just some very, very basic principles, you know, about, for example, lighting, you know, compositing the image, other stuff, you know, the whole creative process of actually creating that cool pictures will set you apart also very, very much. And I see it a lot of the times on the internet. Lots of Instagrammers, you know, they want to work with me, for example, on our brand, but then the whole, you know, the content's just not great enough. And for example, you can use your iPhone pretty much to do everything, you know, if the lighting is correct. If you know what you do. For example, when I first started out on Instagram, I mainly used my, you know, iPhone 6 for all of the pictures that I used. And all the time people ask me, what kind of camera do you shoot this with? It's just the iPhone, you know, the regular iPhone. That's just how it is. And of course, at first I took pictures with my iPhone and they were kind of crappy, you know. You know how they look. And then I did some digging online a couple of years back, actually. And that's when I actually found Skillshare, which is an online learning community, if you don't know what that is. And it's basically thousands of courses in there, ranging from all the different kinds of topics. If you want to know how to take good iPhone pictures, there's a course for that. Do you want to know the basic principles of, you know, branding, like we just said, and stuff like that? Of course, there's a course for that on Skillshare. By the way, actually, it's a course by Gary Vee. I just saw that, which is actually really great. You know, so basically, there's hundreds upon hundreds of courses just for your needs. And the great thing is, they're not, you know, hundreds of hours long. You know, most of the courses just, you know, condense it down to the very, very core principles for you to actually grasp the whole idea, to actually learn pretty fast, pretty efficiently, because you should know that executing is still the most important part. So the other great thing that is, it's really, really affordable. You know, if you go for the annual plan, it's less than 10 bucks a month. I believe 8 bucks a month. What is that? 2 coffees a month less? And you have, You get the idea. And that's where the really, really cool stuff starts, my friends. You know, I know a guy, which might actually be myself, who managed to get all of you people, or actually the first 500 people that sign up for the link down below, to totally free months of, you know, premium Skillshare, where you can just check out everything that's on there. Totally for free, 2 months for free, you know, just sign up down below with the link. The thing is, I would never, never recommend you stuff like that, which I would not use myself. And I really, really think it's awesome. Just tell you how it is, you know. Number three is editing. And of course, again, it might sound pretty basic, but still, lots of people don't really know how to use their editing software properly. And sometimes it's only a couple of tweaks that you need to know actually to make great, great content and do some editing tricks that, you know, no one else. And that's why it's actually great to look up some tutorials of different kinds of, you know, people who do editing tutorials. Because everyone has their own style. Try to compare, try to actually grasp their idea. What are they trying to do? What kind of look are they trying to go after? Try to replicate that for yourself and, you know, try to see their whole creative process. Then you just take all of the infos that you have gotten from all these tutorials and then you actually kind of come up with your own idea, and that will come naturally, which is eventually what will happen and should happen if you want to actually stand out from the crowd. Yeah, at the beginning, it's very, very great to, you know, just try out different styles and see what resonates with you the most. And the last thing here is actually what I call the plow through gene, actually. And, you know, I've talked to lots of creators, you know, myself included. One thing that I actually think sets every one of those people who eventually made it in the end apart from the other ones is they've actually plowed through whenever they had some sort of doubts about their content. You know, lots of the times I talk to people who, you know, have like hours upon hours of footage stored already, but they just don't upload them for whatever reason. They think, okay, I could have done a little bit better here on that part. You know, I could have looked a little bit better. You know, the camera's angle is a little bit, you know, crooked, stuff like that. But it's actually for nothing, because you never know. And you know, sometimes you just don't feel right. Sometimes it just feels bad. And it's actually a natural thing, because, you know, I believe that's what drives creators to actually always become better all the time, always try to learn something new, always try to implement new techniques and try to better yourself. And you know, sometimes it just doesn't work. And myself included, I have some very, very, you know, bad videos in my opinion, which I still decided to upload. The funny thing is, a couple of those videos where I've actually struggled to, you know, upload them, where I actually thought, okay, I might not upload this thing, I still uploaded it. And for some reason, some of them are the most viewed videos, for example, on my channel. So you can never know, you know, it always looks different to yourself than to, you know, it is from for someone from the outside. So just plow through it, you know, it does not matter. And if it's sometimes it's, if it's not good, what's gonna happen, you know? What's the worst thing that could happen? Right? So these were my four tips to actually try to set yourself apart. I tried to manage to, you know, keep them really short and concise, because I want you to actually, you know, get something out of this video. Try to at least read yourself into that a little bit, into these four skills. And if you just know the basic principles of them, you're gonna set yourself apart in the long run pretty easily. Because, you know, the crowd is big, but, you know, the top 20%, it's not that hard to actually reach the top 20%. You know, if you know what you're doing. Anyway, my name is Dominic. It's getting to the end of this video. My voice starts cracking again. See you in a couple of days, and bye-bye, my friends.